We know that dark matter and dark energy exist, even though we cannot directly see them, because of the forces that they exert on other objects.
In the case of dark matter, we can see when we observe the movement of objects in the sky and the structure of all of the matter in the universe. The matter that we see, that we are able to detect, the matter that we understand, cannot possibly account for all of the gravity that we see. So that's why we postulate that there is some form of dark matter that we cannot see and that is creating this gravity.
In terms of dark energy, we can measure distances to faraway objects, and we can see that as we look farther and farther away, that the objects are not only getting farther and farther away, but that that expansion that we are seeing is actually speeding up over time. And we don't know exactly what is causing this, but we think it is some sort of vacuum pressure, and we have called that dark energy.
My name is Gillian Beltz-Mohrmann. I am a postdoctoral researcher in the cosmology group at Argonne National Laboratory.
My name is Florian Kéruzoré. I'm a postdoctoral researcher working on cosmological physics at Argonne National Laboratory. So dark matter and dark energy are really important in terms of for understanding the universe, because they make up almost the entirety of the universe. So all of the things that we know, the stars and the planets and everything that is on Earth with us right now, all of that makes up only 5% of the total contents of the universe. And then we have dark matter, that makes up about 25% of it, and dark energy, which is all the remaining 70%. And so that means that if we really want to understand the universe fundamentally, we need to understand exactly what's going on with these two components that make up almost everything that exists in the universe.
One of the biggest challenges about understanding both dark matter and dark energy is that we cannot directly observe dark matter. And the same can be said for dark energy, where we can see its effects on the distances between galaxies, but we haven't been able to directly measure what this energy is or what is creating this accelerated expansion.
In my work, I use a lot of data coming from telescopes. Since working at Argonne, I have also specialized a lot in working with cosmological simulations, so simulations of the universe.
The main thing that I do is run simulations of structure formation in the universe and compare what I see in those simulations to observations of galaxies in the real universe.
The big idea is to have some sort of a universe in a box in which we create a synthetic universe with a given set of cosmological parameters.
I like to think of this as trying to come up with the recipe for the universe, which means that the ingredients are
how much dark matter and dark energy there is and how dark energy is going to evolve with time.
What are the properties of dark matter? What is the relationship between where galaxies live within this dark matter?
And then what we do is we evolve the complete simulation of this universe from very early on, right after the Big Bang, all the way until now.
I think there's something very shocking about realizing that we truly don't understand the majority of the matter and energy in the universe in which we live.
I really do think that we need to achieve a better understanding of these two fundamental properties, which will then allow us to paint a better picture of what our universe is and what it's made up of and how it works.
So I started telling people when I was like 8 that I wanted to be an astronomer. But I do think I got hooked on cosmology because there was so much unknown about it, and the observations are so hard. Like we can't see any of this stuff that we're talking about. We can see the moon and we can see the sun, but the fact that the field was so open and there were so many unknowns, I think is what made me really excited about it.